So this gives me a great idea. Let's use memoization to make parsing very fast. Let's cast our minds back to the glory days of regular expressions and finite state machines. In order to see if a string was accepted by a finite state machine, we'd essentially keep our finger on the state. So on input ABB, ABB, I just sort of keep my finger on this middle state to see where things were going. If I stop here, then the string is not in the language. But if I add one more character, C, A, B, B, C, I just put my finger on it, and I can tell we accept. We're going to use this same put your finger on it trick for parsing, to keep track of where we are, to keep track of which state we're in. Now, for a finite state machine state, that was pretty easy. They were the circles. For a parser state, this is not so clear. So we're also going to solve parsing by putting our finger on it. But just like how non-deterministic finite state machines might require two or three fingers, parsing might also require a number of fingers. It's going to be somewhat complicated. Consider this simple arithmetic expression grammar. It has a starting non-terminal, but then quickly goes to E, E plus E, E minus E, and 1 and 2 instead of number. Let's just make it finite. Suppose the entire input is 1 plus 2, which is in the language of the grammar. And currently, we've only seen the 1 and the plus. Remember that to figure out if something was in the language of a finite state machine, we look at one character at a time. We're going to do pretty much the same thing for parsing. We're going to look at one token at a time. But the question is, where are we now? Well, we don't have states that look like circles, but we do have these rules. In fact, we've got five of them written over here. And if we've already seen the 1 and the plus, and we're about to see the 2, I claim that there are one or two of these rules that match more closely than others. For example, S goes to E, that doesn't seem particularly relevant. The minus sign, that doesn't seem particularly relevant. E goes to 1, if we've already seen the 1 and the plus, we're kind of past that. But these two, E plus E and 2, that's kind of where the action is. That's where we are now in some strong sense. In fact, I'm going to claim that we're right here. In the rule, E goes to E plus E, we've already seen the E and the plus. Here's my finger. And we're about to see the next E. Since I can't always leave my finger on the slide, we often formally draw a red dot in the middle of one of these rules to keep track of where we are. This is one example of a parsing state. The first E is going to correspond to or come from the 1 in the input. Ideally, the second E will match up with the 2 in the input. We've already seen everything to the left of the red dot. We have not yet seen everything to the right of the red dot. The red dot is right where we are now. This is the past, this is the future, this is now.